Hello everyone, it's Jonathan here, founder of Driving Academy, and today we're going to answer a question. Hey, is there an actual difference in driving if the trailer is loaded or not loaded when you're driving a big tractor trailer? So, if you don't know, this is what a tractor trailer looks like, which means that the front part right there, that's the tractor, this back part is the trailer. When you are a truck driver, you actually get paid to transport whatever's in that trailer, which technically makes that trailer the most important part of this entire vehicle because that's where all the valuable stuff is. Now, of course, nothing's more valuable than your life, so that's why we want to make sure that you're safe. So that's why we give the best training in the entire country to all of our students. And if you are interested in getting your CDL license, give us a call, 908-525-3609, so we can show you all the different ways that we can help you out. We're open up 7 days a week. We have payment plans available. We have guaranteed training courses, so you're guaranteed to walk away with the result that you're after. We also have lifetime job placement as well. But now let's get back to the actual question at hand, which is, what is the difference between driving an empty trailer versus a loaded trailer? So there is an actual difference. Maybe some brand newbies won't really see the difference happening, but when it comes to turning and operating the vehicle, there's a few different things that you do have to understand. The first thing is going to be when it comes to driving a manual transmission vehicle, big difference is when you're a fully loaded trailer, you have a whole lot more weight on there, right? Versus an empty trailer, you don't have the weight. So for instance, when you're in the school with us here, we train on empty trailers because legally we can't have cargo inside the vehicle if there's a student driver out there. That means when it comes to driving on the road, we actually tell our students to start off in fourth gear. That's right. Skip all the way to fourth gear because you're empty and you want to make sure that you limit the amount of shifting that you have to do and you can get the speed much faster starting off in fourth gear. However, if you're a fully loaded trailer, that means you have all that weight and you can weigh up to 80,000 pounds when you add the trailer, the tractor weight, and the weight of the load itself legally. And then starting off in fourth gear is probably not going to be the best option. One, you're probably going to stall because there's not enough torque moving forward to kind of move all that weight going forward right from a stop. So you're going to have to start in first or second gear depending on the truck that you're in and depending on how heavy you are, and then gradually build up your speed up that way, right? If you start off in first gear, you ain't never going to stall, so you're good to go there. Now, the other big thing that you have to understand is your actual driving ability when you're driving a loaded versus empty trailer. If you're driving an empty trailer itself, then you can be a little bit more, let's say, reckless, for lack of a better term. You never want to be reckless, of course, but you can take turns a little bit tighter. If you pop over a curb, it's not going to cause that much damage to the trailer itself, right? And us being student teachers, teaching students how to drive all the time, we've seen it all, believe us, right? And that's one other reason why we keep the trailers empty, because all what the students do, and it's not their fault, they're learning, just like you're going to be learning when you contact us at 908-525-3609. We have our guaranteed training courses available for you. But when you're making those silly mistakes, empty trailer is definitely the way to go. Now, once you get to that loaded trailer, that's when damage can actually happen, right? So for instance, let's say you're taking a turn you're going too fast and you're taking a turn too tight. That means that there you have the potential of the whole load shifting. I've seen crazy things where the whole load shifted to the side of the trailer itself, creating a bulge in the trailer and eventually flipping the whole truck and trailer over simply because the driver was reckless driving that vehicle. Also, when you come into a complete stop, right? Say you're slamming on the brakes, you have all that cargo on pallets behind you. If it's not secured properly, all that stuff is going to fall forward, and that's going to be a problem for you. But the biggest thing is going to be running over those curbs. So if you have been driving for any time, any amount of time, I'm sure you've seen a picture like this, which is a truck going over a curb. Now, if it's fully loaded, that means there's a whole lot of weight on that trailer, and now all that weight is transferring onto the curb, which means now your suspension could get all busted up. The trailer can actually tip over to the point where, again, it can flip over and you can cause damage to the trailer and to the goods that you're driving it, right? So it makes it a lot more difficult when it comes to forgiving your reckless behavior when you are driving a fully loaded trailer. So those are the main differences. I guess the pros of driving a loaded trailer versus an empty trailer is, say you're driving in a very, very windy road, it's going to be very hard for that heavy loaded trailer to do anything when it comes to actually moving around, so you're much more stable on the road. And then one of the cons of driving a heavy trailer is that you're going to be using more fuel if you are actually doing a lot of uphill uphill stuff going on with the truck itself, simply because a lot more weight, you need a lot more power to get going. So if you like this video, make sure you click on the like button, and if you have any comments on for the next one, make sure you comment below. But if you do like this content and you want to get yourself a CDL license, you gotta come to the best driving school in the entire country. And that means you gotta come to Driving Academy. Currently we're located in Linden, New Jersey. We have plans of opening up nationwide. So maybe if you wanna open up a driving school one day, give us a call and we might be able to help you out. We've got some things brewing that might be able to really pop this thing over the top and help us get to our goal of helping 1 million people get on the road to freedom. Right now by ourselves, we've gotten ourselves to over the 50,000 person mark, which is a great start, but we've got a whole lot more to go, right? And we need your help to do it. But first thing first, I wanna help you out. That's right, I'm talking to you. So if you're watching this and you wanna get a CDL license, there's only one other thing you gotta do. Give us a call, 908-525-3609, or check out our virtual school tour at cdldrivingacademy.com/tour. Again, cdldrivingacademy.com/tour. We're open up 7 days a week, which means we could work on any kind of schedule that you have. We have payment plans starting as low as $500 down to get yourself started. We have guaranteed training courses, which means we can guarantee, that's right, I said guarantee that you get yourself a CDL license by giving you over 100 hours of training plus unlimited tries at the test itself. So one more time, give us a call, 908-525-3609. Check out our virtual school tour if you want to figure out our pricing at cdldrivingacademy.com/tour. Thanks, and have a fantastic day. Hey, thank you so much for watching this video. If you like it, make sure you hit that like button. Also, subscribe to our channel. It's really going to help us out. Click on that button. And if you want to continue yourself on your road to freedom, here's more videos to watch. There's endless amounts. Hopefully, we get to see each other one day very soon. Thanks.